during this discussion, it would be great if Beverly, I know you've done some bullet points, you said you would.
Behind the screen.
Or Judy wants to say a few words from the Elderly Leaseholders Action Group. but first, yeah, so stick your hand up if you want to speak, but first I'd like to ask Shahina to say a few things about, she's a Notting Hill tenant from St James's, which is a development that Notting Hill owns in Bermondsey. Okay, thank you.
Hello everybody, so I do cause static sometimes. So yes, I'm Shahina and I live in Bermondsey on the St James's estate. So how I became involved with this movement is because I went to a housing summit, and that's when I learned that, you know, it wasn't just us on the estate that were facing the same problems with Notting Hill. And I also met some of the people who have spoken before who also said that they were facing mergers. So my first point is there isn't really much awareness. As a resident, you don't really know what's going on, A, with the housing association themselves, and B, what they're doing in other places. So that's when I realised that this problem is quite widespread. So let me tell you a little bit about being a Notting Hill Housing Association tenant. I moved in 2014, and prior to that, they had already been hiking up, you know, what was meant to be affordable rent. So, as some of the other speakers have said, we as a group of residents got together and said, this is just not acceptable. We wrote to them, you know, contacted them, and absolutely nothing was done. Finally, a few very opinionated and slightly more forceful residents got together and we called a public meeting. So it was when we did that that we could actually have our voices heard. Notting Hill ignored us, but in 2013 we got an agreement put in place where they could only increase our rent by a certain amount. And it was prior to my time, so I don't have all the details. But the following year, they started increasing our rent. So, for example, every year, at a minimum, our rent is increased from anything from an extra £100 a month to some cases 40%. So, again, we started resolving our problems in a very similar fashion. We started to speak to each other. And what we found out is that 5 residents were facing eviction. They had even put certain people in rent arrears. But when we looked into their paperwork, it wasn't that they were rent arreared. It was that when Notting Hill changed their payment company, they hadn't migrated everybody's details. So these people who, you know, just due to basic errors in office management and admin, were getting call letters and being told they were being evicted. So we contacted councillors, we contacted the local MP, we even had a mediator, and we took them to task. We called a meeting exactly like that, exactly like this, and we started asking questions. So my advice to anybody who's in that position is to call a meeting, have somebody who can voice your opinions, and hold them accountable. We hadn't had any repairs. We had people with children who had damp for 5 years. We had hanging low trees that were dangerous. We had a wall that was about to come apart. And it's only recently that we have been given a letter to say any of this is going to be rectified. So my word is well done, Aylesbury people, for standing up for what is your basic right. It's a human right to live in affordable housing. It is a human right to live in good housing conditions. So I say well done to you guys, and keep up the good work.